Welcome to my hat shop. Is this your first time here? Well, I'll do my best to find you a quality piece today. Yes, the tradition of wearing a stylish hat is definitely making a comeback lately. Very exciting. Well, you know, up until 1960s, every gentleman would wear a hat at all times. It was a very essential piece that you wouldn't even leave the house without. Yes, it's definitely much more relaxed nowadays. So, do you know things about hats? Are you just starting out? Okay. So I have a lot of information if you're interested. Yes, I can just explain as we go along. Mm-hmm. So each hat has a different style. When you see a person wearing a hat, you can tell their personality by it. You can also tell the social status of the hat that it covers. I always say that it's a very fun accessory to add to your wardrobe. It makes you stand out in the crowd. Gives you a little playful confidence. Mm-hmm. And we usually go by shape of the face, by the height, by the size of the head as well. So a larger face, a smaller face, it will depend. You would want to have a medium size for those. So a smaller head shouldn't have a huge head. Same thing with a longer head. You wouldn't want to have a very tall head. You want to offset it, highlight it, and accessorize your look. Yeah. Okay. So let's just start with basics. Give you 101 for hats. So in most hats you will see a crown. It can be tall, it can be short. Sometimes it's round, sometimes it's teardrop. This inward curve is called the crease. And then some hats, like this fedora, will have pinched crease here as well. So it's even dents on each side of the crown. Then you will notice most hats will have a band of some kind. Either leather, sometimes it can be belts. Oftentimes it's elastic material or satin. Then you have a nod or a part that you can accessorize and decorate your hat to your liking. You can change it from day to night and vice versa by just adding a little something something. And then, of course, you have the brim. And the brims can be wide, like this one, or short. They can also be turned up or down, snapped up or down. And some of them are moldable, some of them are more stationary and unmovable. Okay. Then when you look inside the hat, you will notice this ribbon. It is sometimes satin, sometimes it's leather, sometimes it's just cotton fabric. And it is called a sweatband. And it is what it's called. It's a band to keep the sweat away from dripping onto your face. It is quite easily replaceable. And then sometimes you can place little felt pieces to the sides to add a size. So if it's a larger hat, you can always shrink it down. The rule of thumb we usually give is if you are half size, always go up because you can shrink the hat by yourself, but it will not stretch unless it's professionally stretched in our studio. Was this helpful? Put this down. So talking about the size, would you mind if I move some of your hair away? Okay. Yes, I'll give you a very gentle. Brush. So just a bit. It's not tugging or anything, is it? Measure up. I'll get my tape. Okay. And I'm using a soft tape to make sure that it conforms with your head, okay? So I'll go around your head. Is this okay? Alright. and down. Measure your forehead. So, okay. All right. Okay. Sit about forehead. The lower part. And measure the height of your forehead. And last measurement I'll need to take is the distance between your ears. Let's go from one side to the other. I might have to put it above your eyebrow, okay? May I? Thank you. Can you see? Let's start on this side here. Well, it looks pretty good. I would think you're a medium to large size, quite common, quite normal size, and it's a size 56. It's a very easy size to find. Yeah. So I'll find you some hats that will fit you the best. Could be yours as well. Okay. That's a beautiful hat. So this is a fedora hat with outback styling, and it's in chocolate coloring. It's 100% wool felt, and it's durable. It's going to protect you from both rain and sun rays. I call this Indiana Jones hat because anyone who puts it on becomes an adventurer. quite universal, can be worn by men and women. In your case, of course, a gentleman's hat. So, would you like to try it out? Okay, so let's take a look at it. You can see it features a wide brim, which means that it's going to protect you from weather. It's going to shade your face from the sun and cover your face from raindrops. It features a beautiful feather. Looks adventurous already. Yes, and it is a classic fedora hat with turned up sides. It is turned down in the back and turned down in the front, which can be fixed if you wish. You can always mold it up. Yes, I usually do it with steam. I'll tell you about it in a second. Okay? So let me brush this one off for you a bit. Trying it on. Alright. I'll just carefully place it on your head, okay? How does it feel? Good. Well, it looks great on you. Yes, definitely an adventurous gentleman. It suits you quite well. I love the height. I love the width of the brim. It fits your face shape perfectly. Let me just pluck some things out in here. Okay. And smooth with a pinched crease. You're welcome to run your fingers. Yeah, it's quite pleasant. Let me just clean it up here and there. How does it feel? Yes, it definitely keeps you both cool and warm. It's just breathable enough for you to use it pretty much at any weather. Let me use some lint roller just to pick up some spots here, okay? Okay, so I'll just use lint roller just to pick up some of the lint. amazing. So what do you think? How does it sit? Good? I think it's all you, honestly. It looks amazing. Very attractive. You like this one? Alright. So I'm going to prepare it for you. Okay? And at the checkout, you'll get it. Let me take it off. I'll put it back. I'll get just the size for you. Move on to other sizes, okay? Types of hats, okay? All right. How about we look at this classic fedora hat? So this one is a straw hat. It is 80% paper straw and 20% nylon. It has a teardrop shape, very classic James Bond, Sean Connery style. Yes, has a beautiful crease here, slightly pinched, but it looks like it doesn't have to be pinched, so you can probably wear it whichever way you wish. Okay, has a cupped turned up on the back. It is a very short brim comparing to this fedora style as well. It's quite a nice clean line. This is a very, very popular style hat. This one specifically is more for summertime, of course. It's breathable. It protects from UV rays. It's quite versatile too. You can wear it with sandals and a classic shoe. You can wear it day and night, depending on what you want to wear with it. Yeah. It has a beautiful, sharp, contrasty band, satin band. Quite nicely set in here. Okay. Then in the back. Inside, we have this elastic, breathable sweatband. Okay. Classic fedoras snap hats, so they can be quite shapeable if wish. Okay. So these also can be worn by both men and women. Look quite attractive. Yes, you can definitely. curl your hair a little bit again. Okay. Okay, just gently moving it out of your face. Okay. Very classic style hat. It's a derby top hat. It features a very tall crown, as you can tell. It's completely flat on the top. It's a very classic look. It has a quite wide band that matches the trim on the brim, right. And the brim itself is a very harsh turned up. It's a very structured hat, very stiff and hard. It's not pliable and not shapeable, unfortunately. Inside, you had leather sweatband mixed with satin for your comfort. It is 100% wool, so it definitely keep you warm. And this style of mostly used during Victorian times, or if you're going caroling, or if you go into a theater, for example, or if you just want to grooge around. Is it correct? Grooge? I forgot the name. Scrooge. If you want to scrooge around. It's also a symbol of capitalism. Prosperity. So, it's a good hat to have in your wardrobe, just in case. Yes, you definitely need to take this hat off once entering different places or meeting people you respect. And the etiquette about removing your hat came to us from medieval times, where knights used to wear helmets, and they would take off the helmet and show trust in people as it was their own way of safety. So when you remove the hat, you show your vulnerability, respect, and peace. When you don't remove your hat front of people, especially people you respect or know, you show mistrust. You show that they should be worried about you, that you're not there to show respect. So the etiquette is quite an old story. So you want to try this one on? Yes, okay. Let me brush it up. Thank you. definitely feel the weight of it. For you. Can you hear it? Yeah. It's quite pleasant. Here on your temples, not too much. Let me brush just a little bit more to make sure that that all of the scales are facing. Always here if you change your mind, okay? Alright. So let's continue the next one. So this hat is quite a timeless look, very classic style. A flat cap. It's a hat of working English glass. You will notice that the English prince is wearing them as well. These are usually sewn with panels. So in this case it's six separate panels. Sometimes they could be one panel as well. This one is made out of 100% cotton. So it's very breathable, very lightweight, more summer, spring kind of weather. These hats feature a very short brim that's almost hidden. It's barely noticeable here. Covered all by fabric. And it has a little stretchy band in make sure that it contours and hugs your head properly. Okay, what do you think? Would you like to try it on? Okay, let's try. On me? Okay, well, let's do it on you. Alright. And here we go. Let me make sure that it's nice and snug behind your head here. Nice neutral gray color that matches pretty much any outfit. This one's not your favorite. Okay. Of course, that's fine. Let's try something else. How about this fun hat? It's a captain's. Features a prominent plastic brim with embroidered and a long flat crown, also with some representation of a ship, and in the back you have adjustable band so that you can tighten it or loosen it depending on your size. The sweatband is nice and wide and cotton. So you'll be very comfortable. And this hat going to stay put. It will not be blown away because of the adjustments, but it will blow away everyone who sees you in it. And this hat is a must before going on high seas. Try it on. It will protect you from the sun, from the wind. Beautiful hat. Everyone will notice you and know that you are the captain of the ship. Try. Okay, let's try it on. How wonderful. Okay. So, you don't have a yacht. Okay. Well, promise me that whenever you do get one, you'll come back and get the set. Yes. It definitely suits you quite well. Alright, let's try the last. modern version of a historic hat that was worn by the Russian Red Army. It features fur. Fake fur, faux fur, and the feature that's mainly recognizable are these ear flaps right here. And you would keep them down for very cold weather, where you need to protect your ears, your cheeks, your chin from the cold. Let me try to show you, okay? Okay. So you can fasten it with this buckle, like so. Or you can lift them up and buckle the same. Okay. this time. That's fine. Let me take it off. When you leave, you look groomed again. Is that okay? Alright, good. Just gently, yes. Okay. So which hats did you enjoy the most? The fedoras? Okay. Would you like to try and get both or just one? You leave our store groomed and well taken care of. Great, so I will prepare your hat for an exit and just pack it up for you, okay? Alright, thank you for joining us and for coming on. Distributing the steam across the hat. And this way we're softening the fibers, loosening those scales. So that once it cools off, it'll take the shape. So now we're going to ply it to our liking. You can round up the edges a bit more, like so. Maybe turn it down more up front, make it more defined. Make the crease more prominent. Dense as well. And then it will cool off in a couple of minutes and the hat will be ready. Make the scales grab onto each other more, interact with each other, and once it stiffens up, it's going to be in our perfect shape. So now it's time to wrap it up and for you to enjoy it. Perfect hat.